DNR deer check stations are set up so the DNR can gain valuable information about the state's deer herd. That's especially true of the check stations in the CWD core area. When you come to a check station, DNR staff will collect information from you on when and where you harvested the deer, the sex of the deer, and staff will age the deer by looking at tooth replacement and tooth wear patterns. If it is a buck, we will record the number of points and take beam diameter measurements. In most cases, the head will then be collected, tagged, and sent to the disease lab where they will be tested for CWD. If you shoot a buck and want to keep the antlers, we can cut them off for you. If you shoot a nice buck and want to do a shoulder mount or European mount, we won't cut anything on the deer at that point. We will register it and then give you instructions on what to do next. The important thing to remember is that we have a process that allows you to get the mount you want, and we can still get the sample we need. And as always, anyone who brings their deer to a check station will receive a commemorative, successful deer hunter patch. After deer heads are collected from check stations, they are delivered to the Michigan Department of Natural Resources Wildlife Disease Lab, located at Michigan State University's Diagnostic Center for Population and Animal Health. Frozen heads must be allowed to thaw completely overnight in order to be processed. Each head is examined to make sure an orange CWD tag with an individual identification number is attached, and the sex and age are verified. Barcodes on the tags are scanned and used to create corresponding sample labels. Deer heads submitted for CWD are also tested for bovine tuberculosis. 3 pairs of lymph nodes are examined from each head and 1 pair of lymph nodes is removed for CWD testing. Tissue from one of the lymph nodes is trimmed off, placed in a pre-labeled tube, and submitted to MSU Diagnostic Center for Population and Animal Health for testing. At the MSU Diagnostic Center, testing is done in 2 stages and there are many steps involved, including scanning tubes, loading information into a spreadsheet, labeling tubes, preparation of the work area, and mixing chemicals. In the first phase, samples are processed in small batches. They're put into a machine that shakes them for several minutes, then a small amount of the sample is taken out and put into a second tube. Chemicals are added and the samples are heated. Then, samples are spun in a centrifuge. Another chemical is added and they are heated again. In the next stage of testing, another chemical is added to the samples prepared in the first stage. Then, a small amount of each sample is put into one of the wells of a test plate. Samples are incubated and another chemical is added. This cycle is repeated again and again before the sample is finally ready to see whether it is positive or negative. From start to finish, it takes the lab about 5 hours to process 3 batches of samples, about 180 altogether. After results are received from MSU, generally 24 to 48 hours after the sample is submitted to MSU, they are added to the database along with the CWD tag information and uploaded onto our website at mi.gov/DNRlab, where they can be checked by hunters. In the event a deer is suspect for CWD, further testing is necessary for confirmation, which can take several weeks. In those cases, the hunter will receive a phone call and replacement kill tag from the lab. For more information on chronic wasting disease, visit mi.gov/CWD.